Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss a problem from chapter number 5, development of surfaces. Let us come to the problem. Draw the development of a tray of equal slopes as shown in figure. So there is a figure given of a tray having equal slopes. Equal slopes represent that the side of the tray is inclined, not a vertical, similar to this one. And dimensions are also mentioned here. So if we can see, bottom rectangle will be having a dimension of 70 by 30, whereas the topmost rectangle will be having a dimension of 90 mm by 55 mm. You can see here I have mentioned the bottom rectangle is 70 mm by 35 mm. As we can compare bottom rectangle and top rectangle, those are at a distance of 25 mm, which has been given here, 25 mm. Now we need to understand that this 25 mm height is a vertical height. Sometimes he may mention an inclined height, then we have to consider that as inclined, but in this particular case he has given a vertical height. So the bottom rectangle as well as the topmost rectangle are divided at a height of 25 mm. Now we need to develop the surface of this particular tray. Developing a surface represents what will be the shape and size of the object when we fully open the structure. So consider, if I open this tray, what will be its shape? So to do further, we have to draw its true shape, that is true front view and true top view. If I consider this as my front view, see here, if I keep my tray as in this angle, this represents my front view. This represents my front view, and from this angle it will be representing a top view. Now I am gonna draw front view and top view of this particular diagram. After that we can develop the surface. Here we will start with a front view. As you can see, front view will be a typical trapezoidal shape, of which bottom width is 70 mm, top width is 90 mm, and vertical height is 25 mm. So first of all, take a reference line and from at any point consider it as a midpoint of the base. Consider whatever the point we are taking it as a midpoint of the base. So for a 70 mm length, midpoint will be at 35. So here I will draw a 70 mm line. So this will represents at a distance of 35 mm from both sides. Now as given, 25 mm is our height between two lines, two trapezoidal lines, that is top and bottom. So from this midpoint, take a 25 mm centroidal line, you can take it as a dotted line, and from this we know that top height is 90 mm. If we divide in half, that is 45 mm from this left hand side and 45 from right hand side. So draw the top line in this manner. Here, so we got the bottom and top lines of the trapezoid. Just we need to join these two points. So as you can see, this represents the front view of the given tray. Now we have to project the same dimension, we have to project the existing point to get the top view. I am simply projecting all the points to the bottom. Now here take a reference line. So this reference line represent the midpoint or centroid of the rectangle. See here, if you see it properly, this is a bottom triangle, and whatever I am taking a reference line, this reference line represent the centroid of the rectangle and a line passing through that centroid, a horizontal line passing through that centroid. So the same centroid will be located here. To get the top view, we have to divide the width in two halves. So we know that our right side width is 35, our right width of the bottom rectangle is 35 mm. So 35 by 2, that will be 17.5 at each side. So from this edge, take a length of 17.5 and at the bottom also mark a point of 17.5. So you will get a total line of length 35 mm. Similarly here, so draw this rectangle. And you will get a bottom rectangle. So as he has mentioned all the points for a given tray, that is for bottom rectangle points are A, B, C and D. For the top rectangle points are E, F, G and H. So I will notate this as a bottom rectangle point as point number A, point number B, C and D. So we got our bottom rectangle. Now we need to draw the upper rectangle. So project the remaining points from here. See here once. So if we consider the bottom rectangle, the whatever the points we are projecting, A and D, here these two points will be represented. See, if it is A, D will be exactly at the back. So write it as A dash and D dash. Similarly here B dash and C dash. Now project the remaining points. Like this. So again we know the width of the upper rectangle is 90 mm by 55 mm. So if we consider this as a midpoint, so 55 by 2, that is 27.5. so again 27.5 from midpoint to the topmost corner here, 27.5. similarly at the bottom also take 27.5, draw the line, extend all these lines and you will get the topmost rectangle. Now this, notate these points as E, F, G and H as given in question. Join the corners and the corners so now you got the exact true shape of the top view of the given tray like this. Now you need to develop the surface. Similarly notate the point E dash, H dash, E dash, H dash, similarly F dash and G dash. So these are the points. Now this is the true shape of front view and top view. Now we need to develop a surface. Consider this our front view. If you consider it in a front view, now developing is nothing but opening the whole tray. We will be opening the tray from one by one. See, if I open this left side of a tray, if you see it properly, if I open this left side of the tray, this will be my side view, front view, and this represents my top view. So after developing or after opening a surface, my instead of this shape, I may say a different trapezoidal shape. So we will be developing this shape in this manner. First of all, you need to take a compass, take radius of a dash and e dash, take a radius of a dash and e dash, and draw a arc up to this horizontal reference line. Do the same on the right side also. After drawing these two arcs, just extend the arcs to the bottom here. Yes, we need to extend the arcs up to the bottom, to the top view. Now project the point H, project the point H to the projected line in this manner. Okay, see, if you observe properly, previously this point, the topmost, this was E and this was H. Now after developing a surface, the same H point and E point will be here. So this point represent new H and E. Now join the points A and E, similarly D and H. And close the trapezoid. So if you observe properly, this represent our left side developed surface of a tray. Similarly, we have to develop all the surfaces. So extend the point G here and F up to this. Next, join the point. First of all, notate the point G and F. Now join the point C, G and F, B. Darken this circle, darken this trapezoid. Okay, so this represents our developed surface from left and right. Similarly, we have to do on the top and bottom of the tray. Just take a radius of C and G. Observe carefully. Take the radius of C and G. We have to take the radius of C, G and draw an arc up to here. Take the radius of C, G and draw an arc up to here. Do the same at all the corners. Take a radius of D and H and we need to draw an arc to here. Take radius of AE, draw the arc this corner. Okay, we need to draw exactly at the G point, not we should not extend up to this further point. We just need to draw up to the G point. Similar the way we had extended this point horizontally, we have to again extend the point up to here. So consider this our final points, these four as final points. Join all the points. Join the trapezoids. for a better view I am providing a hatch here so that you won't get confused. Actually it is your wish, you can provide a hatch or you can just leave as it is. For clear understanding, I am providing a hatch. Okay, after providing a hatch, you can clearly see the diagram. See, this was our initial tray. Now, after developing a surface, you can clearly see our figure exactly matches the developed surface in this format. So, like this, we have to draw the developed surface of a tray, whether it is inclined or a vertical tray. After completion of diagram, you need to notate the points. Mention the dimensions of each and every given specification. Here the top width is 90, similarly topmost here side width is exactly 55. Bottom width of the travius 70 and height was, sorry, width 35. Neatly mention the arrows, provide the dimensions, and that will complete your diagram. Thank you.